take you to a place where my friends foregather. There are vampires, werewolves, ghouls, every kind of monster you could ever imagine.
I am Sador of the Mount Mori. I have come with my forces to conquer you.
Just a minute. You'll forget that you had any trouble.
You are one of his kind now. I suppose you know you broke up my home. I didn't know that you were in a home. When did you get out?
Brothers, let us pray. No!
Deliver this house from all evil spirits, all vain imaginings, projections and phantasms, and all deceits of the evil.
Hey, welcome back, everybody, to another episode of the B Movie Cinema Show, featuring HorrorChick65 and Mr. Hyde.
Hello, everybody.
How's it going?
Well, we already have a blooper off of this one, don't we?
Yep, we do.
Right off the bat.
Yep. So today's movie is called Hillbillies in a Haunted House. And, you know, it does what it says on the tin. We could pretty much practically launch right into the movie from there, because that's pretty much what it is. But the movie is a 1967 American musical horror comedy. That is a mouthful. Film starring Ferlin Husky and Joy Lansing and directed by Gene Yarbrough. The film is a sequel to the Las Vegas Hillbillies of 1966, with Joy Lansing replacing Mamie Van Doren in the role of Boots Malone. And very quickly, the director, Gene Yarbrough, has actually got an interesting filmography for anyone who's a fan of Abbott and Costello, because in the 40s and 50s, he directed comedy teams like Abbott and Costello. He also directed some films, five films for the Bowery Boys, as well as some horror cult movies that are still remembered to this day, such as The Devil Bat, King of the Zombies, She-Wolf of London, and The House of Horrors. Hillbillies in a Haunted House was actually his final theatrical film. So if you want to chat about the plot, as I said, it's not that mysterious, this one.
No, it isn't. And it's funny that you mentioned that this is his last theatrical one, because this is also, well actually, it's not quite the last movie with Basil Rathbone. I thought it was, but he did a movie in 1968 called Autopsy on Phantasma.
Oh, okay.
Which was released after he passed away. And I tried looking for that one, and it was a hard one to find. It's I'm hoping to get a copy, but for some reason, yeah, there isn't a whole lot of information. And of course, Rathbone, he did the voice in The Great Mouse Detective of Walt Disney.
Which is so fitting. I love Basil Rathbone. He's up there for me. One of my absolute favorite leading men. And obviously the first Sherlock Holmes that many of us were exposed to, particularly in North America.
The plot for this one, a pair of country singers and their band are headed to Nashville. The car unfortunately breaks down and they stop overnight at an abandoned house, which turns out to be haunted. A ring of international spies, played by Lon Chaney, Basil Rathbone, and John Carradine, who live in the haunted house, are seeking a top-secret formula for rocket fuel. While it's never revealed to who they are spying, they carry out their activities under the cover of a supposed haunted house, which comes complete with a gorilla lurking in the basement.
Hey, man, it's got everything. Yeah. A dude in a gorilla suit, you can't beat it.
And he features Merle Haggard.
Yay.
Plays himself. So anyways, so yeah, well, without further ado,
yeah,
let's just get right into it. And I get to go here this time. Go full screen so we don't muck it up. All right, here we go. Oh, I guess I should, fuck, I should just sit back.
Well, this music definitely sets the tone, doesn't it?
You want to get up and dance.
You want a square dance.
Giddy up, Bart.
Nashville.
I still don't feel so hot.
It's jamboree time. Jamboree time.
I can hardly wait to meet up with the crowd.
It's jamboree time. Jamboree time.
Come on, let me hear it clear and loud.
We're on our way. We're on our way.
We're on our way to a swinging jamboree.
Yeah, we're on our way.
We're on our way. We're on our way to Nashville, Tennessee.
Here comes Sheriff Roscoe. A step back, dude.
Got it.
It's okay. Sorry you got caught in the middle.
What's going on?
Spies.
Spies?
That's right. Over Nakamie City and these hills. They're all over the place.
Let's get out of here.
Keepers, you have to relax. You're headed for a nervous breakdown if you don't unwind a little bit.
Don't worry, man.
They won't bother you unless you carry some secrets.
That dude is so chilled out. They were just firing a gun about 4 inches from his nose.
Well, nice, we're doing to well, good luck. The road's clear. You can pass on.
Thank you.
Pass on. Good choice of words.
Woody, we have to do something about Jeepers.
Yeah, I know.
He's been working night and day, and I think his nerves are on edge.
Jeeps?
What?
Now, Jeepers, you know we appreciate what you've done for us.
We sure do, Jeeps. And I realize you worked awfully hard to try to get the show lined up so we could appear back in Nashville.
That's right. And the show isn't until tomorrow night.
Right.
And Woody and I are going to find a nice, quiet, restful place for you. We'll see that you relax.
Yeah. Relax.
And then she's going to cuddle up to Woody.
Relax.
This for a second and say, anybody who said the last movie that we just watched was really horrible, this is me saying, oh, my dear. Okay, carry on.
Howdy.
Hi. Thought this place is closed.
Well, it should be. Nobody ever comes this way.
Where are we?
Sleepy Junction.
Sleepy Junction.
Where are we?
Sleepy Junction.
Oh.
Hey, Woody, we're in Sleepy Junction.
Sir, we're looking for a nice, quiet place.
I wonder if they're in Sleepy
tonight.
Junction.
Motel.
You think maybe they're in Sleepy Junction?
Hotel.
I'm just saying.
A boarding house?
Ma'am, there just ain't nothing around here.
What happened to this place?
Everybody moved out. Moved over to Acme City. They got a big missile plant there, and the people go where the work is.
Jeeps, I'm sorry, buddy, but we'll find a place for you so you can rest and relax.
That's okay. I feel good now. I'm not nervous or anything. Thunder?
Thunder.
Yeah, looks like a storm's coming up.
Don't look too good.
Hey, I just thought of something. There's the old Beauregard Mansion. Oh, it's quiet, all right. At least you get out of the rain and have a place to stay.
Well, where is it?
Just follow this road.
Thank you.
Maybe get some gas while you're there? Oh, maybe that's a good idea.
And they're in a convertible in an impending thunder and lightning storm. That's always a plus. I love the car.
Hey, wait! I forgot to tell him it's haunted.
I love the name Beauregard Mansion. That does have a sort of haunted feel to it.
Hurry up, that rain's gonna be coming down any minute.
I mean, sure, just leave the...
They're going to put the roof up?
Jeepers, come on!
You're not afraid, are you?
Oh, no! Well, come on! What are you two waiting for?
I'm waiting for my courage to come back.
Come on, let's go.
I'm waiting for you to put the roof up in the car.
I think my courage just left again.
Oh, jeepers, it's just a shutter that fell.
Oh, I love the creaking door.
It's awfully dark out there all of a sudden.
Yeah.
Listen. I don't like this place one little bit.
I said put that monkey back in the cage.
All right, all
Fine.
I want him to stay in the cave. He comes out once more, I'll kill him.
Oh, Anatole, you get in there. Be a good boy. Be a good boy. No.
Be quiet.
You shouldn't talk to Anatole like that. He's sensitive.
Stay away from that monkey.
You'd be calling him a monkey, I'll slap you right in the head, buddy.
Jeeps, go get the television set. Let's start a fire.
Okay.
Television set that's in the car.
Mm-hmm. I'll put the top up on the car, but it don't work.
Hey, this is kind of fun, you know? Sort of like camping out. I'd like to explore this place once we get settled down.
Jeez. I keep expecting him to drop it.
Woody, there's something out there.
What?
Calm down, what?
Listen, I saw a thing out there.
Jeepers, you're a nervous wreck. Now you're seeing things.
I am?
Boy, you're in bad shape.
He's like the Reverend Jim of this film.
I want you to know, Jeeps, no matter what happens, you've been one of the best little business managers anybody could have. But you need to unwind. Come over here and sit down in this comfortable chair and just relax, man.
I've got to relax.
Sing him a song, Woody. That always relaxes him.
All right. Jeez, this is one I standing by the rope the other day.
I got a soft spot for country singers.
Living in a train.
Oh, yeah.
Let me get in here.
You cast a spell on me the first time we met. Bewitched and enchanted at first glance. I didn't know then the spell that I was in. Now I'm living in a trance. Living in a trance. In a world a lost romance. I never had a chance. Living in a trance. Living in a trance.
He's sleeping like a baby.
Is he? So
who's the audience?
Who's there? Wait a minute, I'll see who it is. Who's there? Come on, speak up. Who is it?
Nobody.
Well, come on in, then.
You a ghost?
Not yet, but you darn near scared the life out of us.
Me too.
What are you doing here?
We're just passing by. We thought we heard guitar music coming from this place.
Oh, that was me. You live around here?
Just over the hill. We figured if it was a ghost, must be friendly if it plays a guitar. What made you think it was a ghost? Because this place is haunted. Nobody comes near here.
Well, we've been here for quite a while and nothing has happened.
You're one of the lucky ones.
Oh, I don't think nothing will happen. Come on in, warm yourselves with the fire.
Okay. Yep, there's all kinds of strange lights and strange sounds always coming on around this place. Somebody comes in to see if they're real, leaving just like that.
Well, let's leave, just like that.
Oh, jeepers, don't be a baby. We haven't heard a thing.
Say, aren't you Woody Weatherby?
I'm guilty.
I knew it. He's a big star.
Thank you very much. I'm proud you heard of me. This is Boots Malone.
Hi.
and my manager, Jeeves.
Heard of you folks, too. We plan to sing a little.
How about singing one for us?
We'd like to.
I feel like we're auditioning an act.
You never know where you'll find us.
Nightmare.
There is one song that we sang about this mansion, an old tomcat, one of the ghosts here. Years ago, this song was made famous in these parts.
It's what happens when you grow up with hee-haw.
Now, old Uncle John had troubles of his own. Had an old yellow cat that wouldn't leave home. He tried everything he knew to keep the cat away. He even gave it to a preacher and he told him for to stay. But the cat came back, the cat came back. I thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, cause he wouldn't stay away. Now he gave the old cat to the man in the balloon. He told him to leave him with the man in the
shotgun by the U.S. of A.
Everybody said, 10 miles away to pick the man up dead. But the cat came back, the cat came back. I thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, cause he wouldn't stay away. Now the cat was a terror, and they thought it was best to give him to a fella who was heading out west. The train went around the corner and it hit a broken rail. Not a soul aboard the train lived to tell the tale. But the cat came back, the cat came back. I thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, cause he wouldn't stay away. Now the farmer on the corner's gonna kill a cat at sight. He loaded up his gun full of nails and dynamite. Well, he waited in the garden till the cat came around. 7 little pieces of the man was all they found. But the cat the cat came back. I thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, cause he wouldn't stay away.
Do you sing any love songs?
Sometimes.
Would you sing one tonight?
The minute you're gone, I cry. The minute you're gone, I die. Before you walked out of sight, I'm like a child all alone at night. I stare into emptiness. I'm filled with such loneliness. The world goes from right to wrong. The minute you're gone. The minute you're gone, I see. Oh, how lonely a man I'll be. My life would be oh so good if I couldn't be with you. The minute you're gone, I see. The minute you're gone, I
thought we got away with just the one there.
The minute you're gone, the minute you're gone, I see. Oh, how lonely a man. My life would be oh so good if I couldn't be with you. The minute you're gone, I pray. The minute you're gone, I say, please don't stay away too long. The minute you're gone, 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 gone.
Oh, it's just yeah.
Well, there's nothing there. He's
suppose maybe it's mass hypnotism.
That's hypnotism.
That's what I said.
Maybe we all been working too hard.
Well, I, for one, do not believe in ghosts. And I think we ought to investigate. Isn't anyone coming with me?
Are you sure you saw it?
I think so. Oh, I don't know. I heard a sound, and I was so frightened.
Look, maybe we better get out of here while we can.
It could have been my imagination.
Boy, between the three of us, there's sure a lot of imaginating going on.
One thing for sure, there's something funny about this house.
Well, I don't think it's so funny.
And I'm not laughing at all. Oh, maybe it's an owl.
An owl? Doing what, dragging a chain to his nest?
Look, I do not believe in ghosts, and there must be some explanation for all of this.
Where are you going?
To continue the search.
Look, Boots, this is an old empty house. I know there may be a few ghosts in here, but I think we've searched long enough.
I think we ought to get out of here myself.
I'm with you. What's wrong now?
I saw
What? What?
I don't know what it was.
I'll go check the car.
Come on. Poor jeepers. This isn't a very relaxing place for you, is it?
No.
My dear Dr. Himmel, we have more important things to settle than your concern with that monkey.
It infuriates me.
Of course it does. We've made little choice in the matter.
I knew from the beginning that it was a mistake.
That was not your decision to make. Maximilian is my man.
Yes, of which you so consistently remind us.
From the moment we began this project.
You forget that I am the contact with Dr. Fu. Without me...
Without you, we might be much safer.
Indeed, we might. You've been warned again and again to use the secret entrance, yet tonight you walked right into the house as if you were some neighbor on a social jaunt.
I saw a strange car, and I decided to make an investigation.
Such foolish investigation endangers the whole project.
No matter what your authority, you've no right to take such risks,
especially since we're so close to achieving our goal.
You know perfectly well that we often have visitors who are curious to discover if this is really a haunted house.
The simple fact is that if you had contacted us by radio, we could have notified you of our visitors.
What is done is done.
So we're no longer safe.
You have always known this was not a safe business to be in.
But tonight is our last night. It's foolish to endanger the entire project.
Don't worry. Everything's going to be all right.
Bad news.
Why? What happened?
Car won't start.
Oh, no.
And the seats are wet.
Well, guess we'll just spend the night here. Jeeps, you can help me build the fire up some.
We'll bank it so it'll last until morning.
And I think we ought to stick real close together.
Good thinking.
Boots, I want you to... Boots? Boots? Boots!
Oh, boys, here I am. Come and see what I found.
Where are you? What do you mean, running off?
Well, it's just down this hall.
Well, we've got to stick together. Yeah, we got to stick together.
I'm sorry.
We don't know what's going on in this house, and anything can happen.
Okay. Come on and see what I found. When I open this door, you won't believe what's inside.
By now, I'd believe anything.
They could have called her boobs instead of boots.
You're right. I don't believe it.
Isn't it beautiful?
You put your eye out with those things.
Forever right in this one little room. It's so elegant. Maybe this is the room of the great lady of the house. It's been kept exactly as she left it. Way back in the Civil War days, when she was a Southern belle.
Please, no more singing.
Oh, it did say musical.
Beautiful gowns, satin and lace from across the sea. Gowns, gowns, beautiful gowns, bring back a precious memory. A summer night, twinkling stars above, a night so right for people in love. As we dance, dance, I realize the gown I was wearing hypnotized, so I gave it. Dance through the night in my lovely gown of white.
Come on, wrap it up now. Neil stringing himself up by his desk. I'm gonna hear a thud in a minute.
A night so right for people in love. As we dance, dance, I realize the gown I was wearing hypnotized, so I gave it. Dance through the night in my lovely gown of white.
We got to get out of here.
Oh, but it's so beautiful. I could stay here forever.
Well, let's go.
Yay.
McMahon? Is someone there?
Yes, Madam Wong. There are three of them.
What beautiful trespasses. Who are you?
I'm Woody Witherby. Boots Malone and Jeepers.
Delighted. Now, tell me, what are you doing in my house?
Oh, we didn't know it was your house.
I bought the Borogat Mansion so that I could restore it to its original beauty. We didn't mean to trespass. Oh, never mind. Just tell me, what are you doing here?
Well, it looked like a storm was coming up, and we needed a place to stay.
Come, let us leave this room.
Oh, look at Lon Chaney Jr.
Of course you cannot stay here.
You'd really ache there, Lovin.
Haven't my ghost bothered you?
Well,
are they real ghosts?
Of course they are.
I told you we should have gotten out of here.
Well, if you just let us spend the night. You see, we're entertainers, and we're on our way to Nashville, Tennessee to do a jamboree there. I'm afraid our car won't start. And, well, we're going to have to wait until morning.
Tell me, what kind of entertaining do you do?
I'm a singer, and I pick a guitar.
That's debatable.
How charming. And what do you do, my dear?
I sing and dance.
Nice, nice.
And strip?
Are you an entertainer?
Not exactly.
What are you exactly?
I are exactly his business manager.
What's going on?
I don't know, but it looks phony.
You seem real nice to me.
Pulled my finger.
I have decided that you may stay, at least for tonight.
Well, fine.
Let me warn you, stay in that room. You'll be much safer.
We'll stay right by the fireplace.
Good.
We sure do. Hey, they've gone.
Where'd they go?
They didn't go out that door.
Maybe she was a ghost, too?
Sure seemed real to me.
Well, anyway, she was nice, letting us stay here and all tonight.
Well, let's settle down and try to get some rest.
All right.
Woody? Hey, Woody. You asleep?
Yeah.
Boots?
What's wrong?
I can't sleep.
Oh, for heaven's sake. Well, let us sleep anyway.
We're crying out loud, Jeeps.
Watch TV or something.
Yes, sir, ladies and gentlemen, for a terrific car buy, hurry on down right now to Acme City Sales. And now for a full hour of country and western music, here is Merle Haggard.
There is no escape.
I played a brand new record on the jukebox. I scarcely could believe the song I heard. It told of how you left me for another. It was almost like I couldn't every word. Someone told my story in a song. The lyrics told of happiness and all. Then it told of how you done me wrong. Someone told my story in a song. must have seen the way it done me. For he told it all and never missed a line. He told of swinging doors and the jukebox. He even knew I almost lost my mind. Someone told my story in a song. The lyrics told of happiness and home. Then it told of how you've done me wrong. Someone told my story in a song.
Now we give you Jim Kent.
Turn it off, James.
Hi there, shoes. You're the one she wore last night.
Ah, dear.
Was she with him? Did he hug and hold her tight? Or was she just out walking, like she said, down by the sea? Tell me, shoes, was she stepping out on me? Oh, say there, telephone, did he call here and talk to her? Did he say he'd meet her at their rendezvous?
Woody, good.
Did you hear her say,
what the hell?
Couldn't wait to be with him. Is that why she wasn't here to answer you? Hi there, pretty dress. Are you the one that she would choose? When I called, were you out with one or with two? Did he put his arms around you as he held her tenderly? Tell me, dress, was she stepping out on me?
'Cause she didn't like your singing.
Woody, wake up. Boots,
what's going on?
We're crying out loud, Jeeps.
Look at the TV. Look at the television.
It's very nice, Jeepers.
Yeah, he picks a mean guitar. Now let's go back to sleep.
Oh, I saw these two weird faces on the television.
Yeah, you're watching the Late Late Show.
What Late Late Show? Listen, I saw that Chinese lady and her friend.
Well, so did I.
I mean on the television.
Jeepers, you're in bad shape. You need a long, long rest. If you don't stop seeing things, you're going to end up in the funny farm.
I think we're already in the funny farm.
I'm hearing things.
They are entertainers.
Oh, really?
Of course they are.
You take their word unconditionally?
They were carrying guitars when they met.
Yeah, two or three of them.
Anyone can play a guitar. That doesn't make entertainers.
In fact, it could well be a cover disguise.
I believe they're from the master organization to halt enemy resistance.
M-O-T-H-E-R.
He's right.
Oh, come now. They are not mother agents.
I'll take care of them. The torture wheel. The rack.
And the Iron Maiden.
Effective, but primitive.
We have other methods. Quicker and surer.
No. We must not waste time eliminating three who are obviously nothing more than what they appear.
Then you still think that they're entertainers?
You don't want us even to question.
I thought we had resolved that problem.
Well, I suppose we must bow to our judgment in this matter.
As long as I am in charge, you must.
I wish I could be as sure of them as you are.
Dr. Himmel will continue to observe them while I attempt to contact headquarters.
Yes?
Who are you?
Agent Ming Toy, 38-24-36.
The chief.
One moment, please.
Good evening, Dr. Fu.
Gregor, have you the rest of the formula?
No, but Maximilian is leaving almost immediately with Madame Wong. Let him make contact tonight with the agent of the Acme City missile plant, at which time they'll receive the balance of the formula.
Excellent.
When we receive the balance of the formula, we'll report back to you at once.
I will be expecting your call.
Meantime, may I suggest that you have everything in readiness for the test?
Of course.
Hung low out.
Well, now it's up to you. I suggest that you keep in close radio contact.
We will. Come, Mac.
I need to. I forgot. Max! Don't you realize we have important business?
Yeah.
Gentlemen, this is no time for disagreement. Max, here's your laboratory smock, your identification card, and your badge. Good luck.
Yeah. Now what? Oh, he's a big meanie. I think we got the message.
Hi there. Working kind of late.
Scientists have no country music.
You scientists have really worked.
Yeah, that's right.
Say, you're new here, aren't you?
Yeah, sure.
I thought so. I didn't recognize your face. What project, John?
It's top secret. No comment.
Oh, that's all right. I know all about them. I've been working here for 5 years. The things I know and the things I've heard, you wouldn't believe. I tell you one thing. If anybody wanted to be a spy, the thing to do is to become a janitor. Janitor knows everything that goes on.
I ain't got time for conversation. Now let me by, will you?
Sure. See, you're cleared for top secret.
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, that's pretty
good. I was thinking that about the janitor. He's going to be the real spy. Janitor has to be.
Told you I ain't got time for conversation. Now let me by, will you?
Locked out, huh?
It looks like it.
That's okay. Don't wait. I got the key. As long as you're cleared with security.
Thanks a lot.
Glad to help.
Hey, ain't you forgetting something?
Oh, thank you.
Are you George?
Yes.
You have the formula?
Yes.
Give it to me. You'd betray your country. You'd betray us. Ah!
Don't try to say anything. I'll get help for you.
That's a lot of numbers for 911.
Yeah, Chief. This is Jim. My partner's just been shot. Yeah. You better get an ambulance over here right away. No, he hasn't said anything yet. I'll follow through. You better hurry. Okay, will do. Don't try to say anything.
Oh,
take it easy.
The old Beauregard mansion.
The mission is completed.
Do you have the formula?
Yes.
That's what we've been waiting for. I'll be glad to get out of this cold, damp cellar. We both need a vacation, Gregor.
Mm-hmm.
Florida. The Caribbean.
Wait a minute. Mexico?
Puerto Vallarta. Ah, marvelous. Come on, let's call the chief. Just to let him know our mission was successful, we'll be calling with the formula soon.
I don't believe in ghosts. I don't believe in ghosts.
I don't believe in ghosts.
I don't believe in ghosts. Not about that door.
It looks as though he's waiting for someone. Or he may be initiating an investigation, whatever Madam may think. Madam is not always right. Maybe making a grave mistake. I don't think they're entertainers. They're not in costume.
True, quite true.
Yes?
It looks like we are being followed.
Can you lose them?
Of course we can.
It looks like Basil Rathbone was 75 when he did
this. Are you all right?
We lost.
He was born in 1892.
Nice. That's probably what lost.
I wonder. Perhaps we should question one of our visitors.
Hmm? What did you say?
You awake?
Awake? How do you expect me to sleep when you're roaming around half the night?
Sorry about that, Chief.
That's a bad sign, Jeeps. What were you talking about?
I don't know. It's the first time I heard it.
Well, when you figure it out, tell me all about it when I'm wide awake.
I'm telling you, there's something going on in this house.
Sure.
Well, I can't be imaginating all of this.
I don't know. You've been doing pretty good at it. Now go back to sleep.
I can go to sleep. You hear that?
It all depends on what it sounds like.
Sound like somebody moaning or something.
Yeah, the wind.
Oh. What's that?
I don't know. Let me see.
Shutters?
I don't think so.
Maybe nothing, huh?
Maybe the branches hitting up against the
Yeah.
Now, that sounded like something.
Imagination.
You think?
Boots?
Anyone saw a gorilla walking?
He's gone. Well, don't panic. Don't panic. We would have hurt the door by the way it squeaks. Let's try the hall.
Boots? Boots?
Where are you, Boots? Check the closet. Anything in there?
Just the weird wolf. Oh, weird wolf!
Wait a minute.
For what?
We can't forget Boots.
Oh, man.
What am I running for? I didn't say anything. Come on.
Stupid gorilla. Oh, shut up! Don't pick on poor old Anatole all the time. He's not so bad. Don't you remember I said just now that we ought to question one of our visitors?
Yes.
Well, he must have heard us talking and he wants to help us. The only smart thing he's ever done.
Jeeps, we've got to separate. I'll go upstairs. You go outside and look around.
Okay. Say, Woody.
Yeah.
You know, after really thinking about it for 3 or 4 seconds, don't you think we ought to stick together?
You're not afraid, are you?
Well, I never won any bravery contest.
Why don't you take that hat off? Might be a bad look.
Okay.
Is he afraid someone from the Confederation is going to shoot him?
I thought the front was bad.
And it's spooky out here. Boots? Ooh, Boots!
Hey, honey. Boots, where are you?
Well, she's not out here. Let's go back in.
Hold it. I don't see anything.
Me neither. Let's go back.
They're getting too close. Then do something.
Did you hear something?
Must be wind.
Yeah, I guess so.
Move the ghost a little closer. All right.
Jeeps, I think something's behind us.
You sure?
Think so.
Think we ought to look?
I'm almost afraid to.
I'll count to three, and we'll both turn and look. One. Two.
Two and a half.
Three.
Come on, Jeep, hurry! Jeep! Jeep, where'd you go?
Woody! Help!
What are you doing down there?
Well, I ain't looking for new talent.
They seem thoroughly frightened.
This should get rid of them once and for all. Doesn't we're going to have to take drastic measures. Should we question the girl now?
No. Let's wait, at least until Madame returns.
Are you afraid of her?
We're all dependent on each other in this operation.
We could still question her.
George, my dear friend, without Madame Wong, we get no payment for our services. Well, I think it's imperative we wait until she returns.
But we could start questioning her.
I have no intention of jeopardizing our position with Madame. I suspect she'll be angry enough when she sees the young lady.
It's not our fault.
I know, the gorilla.
Hey, Woody. Man, I'm putting his hat back on.
Wonder where she went to.
Stand right where you are. I suggest you raise your hands very high. Higher.
You idiots.
The gorilla did it.
I told you to leave them alone.
Nevertheless, I decided that we should question one of them.
Perhaps you are right. Do not scream, dear. Maximilian has a nervous finger.
Perhaps you'd better answer a few questions.
We don't have time to answer questions. Our girl singer is missing.
How long have you been contact agents?
The only agents we know get 10%.
What does that mean?
That means we're entertainers. Now, look, I've got to find my girl singer.
Hold it! What proof do you have that you're an entertainer?
Don't sing. Don't
sing. My guitar?
He's going to sing.
Look, that girl may be in trouble.
If you're an entertainer, you can play anytime. Now, go on.
Make it a quick one.
Well, perhaps you are entertainers.
Now, will you mind telling me what's happening?
Have you ever heard of M-O-T-H-E-R?
M-O-T-H-E-R. That spells mother.
I know Mother McCree and some other songs about mother.
Mother is master organization to halt enemy resistance.
Mother.
Sure for him.
Hey, that's clever, huh?
My name is Jim Meadows, Mother Agent number 30. We're after an organization whose sole purpose is espionage and counter-espionage. They will contact and sell to anyone. I thought you were contact agents.
We wouldn't know a contact agent if we saw one.
Tell me one thing. How did you get here?
Well, it's a long story. Yesterday, we were driving down the highway on our way to Nashville.
All right, let's begin. What's your name?
Boots Malone.
Boots Malone.
Otherwise known as Boobs.
Her name is Boots Malone.
Is that all the information you got from her?
That's all we have. We'll kill her.
Oh, Max, shut up.
It's my opinion, Boots Malone is a code name.
Not possible.
Boots. What could that mean?
I don't know. Ah, Malone.
Malone.
Ma, ma.
That's it. Ma is a colloquialism for mother.
She's a mother agent just as we thought.
Now,
Lone.
Lone. L-O-N-E.
Got it.
L-1.
She is mother agent L-1.
What are you talking about? My mother's in Las Vegas. You leave the interrogation to us. You go make contact with headquarters, and Max, give them the formula.
We have been waiting.
We have the balance of the formula. Dr. Himmel will read it to you. C3, H5, radical O number 3.
Is that all?
No, there's more.
It would be much simpler if you talk. Talk? Talk about what?
4, Emmy Desole, Athalimang.
Maybe they can sing it.
That's what works the line.
Don't encourage them.
Could you repeat that?
We have ways of making people talk.
We have ways.
Or Emmy Desole, Athalimang.
You have waited so long for someone.
Help me, somebody! I don't belong in this general! Now I think perhaps you had better answer a few questions. All right! Did Mother send you? I told you, my mother's in Las Vegas.
This is the bedroom of the lady that lives here.
Nobody lives here. This place has been for sale for years. Well, there is somebody living here.
Maybe it's her ghost.
I'll have to see that before I believe it.
That's where we saw that weird wolf over there.
In that closet there.
Weird wolf.
Come on, take a look. Here's your werewolf. Come take a look. Here he is.
Well, that's sure going to a lot of trouble just to scare a guy.
This whole house is rigged.
We gotta get out of here. Let's go find that girl.
Put her in there. That will make her talk. Help! 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 Help!
I have some trouble relocating all this equipment in our new assignment.
Well, let's start dismantling it.
No, we better wait till we get a report from Dr. Fu.
Mm-hmm. We should have heard from him by now.
There's no need to be anxious. It'll take some time to put the formula through. Elaborate tests to be made, and there are two parts to the formula.
Could you determine what the ingredients were?
No. Of course, I didn't have time to examine it carefully. There are some strange, unusual components. Maybe something entirely new in atomic research. Let's see. There's nothing here I recognize.
Do you think maybe we should split up?
Well, all right. Why don't you take upstairs? I'll take outside.
What about me?
Why don't you go with him? Oh, by the way, what does she look like?
Blonde, blue eyes. Very beautiful.
You have been tricked. The formula is a fake. You gave me the formula for nitroglycerine and an antihistamine.
How can that be?
Are you certain?
We are certain.
Our contact must have been a mother agent.
It is too dangerous to stay there. Move quickly to your next assignment.
What about the girl?
Poor Max. How you would love to dispose of the girl.
The girl can identify us. We can leave her here. No one will ever find her. No one will even hear her.
Help! Help!
It's a shame this movie doesn't have better pacing, because it could have been a lot more entertaining, I think, if the pacing was quicker. It's just dragging out.
Our next assignment is in Alamogordo.
Oh, I'm looking forward to that. The dry climate will be wonderful for my sinuses.
But I'll miss this house.
It has been fun, hasn't it? Perhaps we could create another haunted house.
No.
Could we fly the ghost once more?
No.
Oh, just once more.
We'll find something else that will be just as fulfilling. Max, go check the car. Greta and Dr. Hillmill will take care of the others upstairs. Come, we'll take the passageway.
Looks like John Carradine and Lon Chaney Jr. were the same age, 61 when this was made, and yet Lon Chaney Jr. looks so much older. He looked really unwell of him.
He was a heavy smoker too, right?
I was kind of reading back on his bio, Chaney Jr., and he actually tried to kill himself with sleeping pills in the late 40s. It's fascinating read.
Well, that's some trick, isn't it? You sure it's a trick?
Well, sure it's a trick. What else could it be?
It could be a ghost. Oh, sure does look real, doesn't it?
Yeah. Go away. You don't scare us.
Leave my house. You are an intruder. Leave my house.
Yeah, there's the real ghost.
Now, if they look real enough,
so do the guns.
After them. Help! Let me out!
Right?
I think so. Well, am I glad to see a friendly face?
It was open.
Who are you? I'll explain later.
And open it herself.
I don't think they could close it because her boobs were too big.
I was going to say that, but you know.
I said it for you.
Where'd they go?
I don't know.
That girl, they must be playing games again.
Go stop it.
This time I'll kill him.
Not a girl, huh?
Give yourself up. Give yourself up.
Leave my house. You are intruders in my house.
But you're not one of ours. A ghost! A ghost! A real one!
You fool! There are no ghosts!
But I saw him!
You'll fool him.
Get the gun, Woody! Put the fire around, get the gun!
Come on, Woody!
Come on, Woody! Get over there. Face the wall, both of you.
Yes, ma'am.
Isn't that nice, friendly Chinese lady?
Not very friendly right now. Go on.
You shot Anton, you bastard.
You know, I really enjoyed that. I didn't like him at all.
You could have spanked the monkey instead of shoot the monkey.
You have taken my name and my house. You have disturbed the dead.
You think?
Is that a promise? You will look me up in Nashville.
When I make a promise, especially to a beautiful girl like you, I don't break it.
Thank you.
I guess the car's drying out.
It's very grateful.
Thank you.
You got a medal for this.
Glad to help. Just mail a medal to Nashville.
Oh, my God.
You thought you'd escaped.
We're on our way to Nashville, Tennessee. We're living it up tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, we travel. That is, most of the entertainers in the country music field. I'd say better than 100,000 miles a year. A lot of shows we work, we're not lucky enough to have women on them. Tonight, we're real fortunate. Here's another beautiful blonde dressed in a beautiful blue, Marcella Wright.
Now we're strangers, completely strangers. When we meet, you turn and look the other way. How can we be strangers? Completely stranger. When we were so in love just yesterday, on the night that we met, it was true love at first sight. You held me in your arms, and your arms felt oh so right. Our love seemed to blossom as the days grew into years. Then you went away and filled my heart with tears. And now we're strangers, completely strangers. I just can't believe you take your love from me. Now we're strangers, completely strangers. And I'm alone with just a memory. Now we're strangers, completely strangers. When we meet, you turn and look the other way. How can we be strangers, completely strangers? When we were so in love just yesterday. When we were so in love just yesterday.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of my favorite singers, one of my favorite people, Mr. Merle Haggard.
Merle? Wait, there's more.
This old smoke little bar is something I'm not used to. I gave up my home to see you satisfied. I just called to let you know where I'll be living. It's not much, but I feel welcome here inside. And I've got swinging doors if you box.
and the barstool. My new home has a flashing neon sign. Stop by and see me anytime you want to. Cause I'm always here at home till closing time. I've got everything I need to drive me crazy. I've got everything it takes to lose my mind. And in here the atmosphere is like heartaches. Thanks to you, I'm always here till closing time. I've got swinging doors, a jukebox, and a bar stool. My new home has a flashing neon sign. Stop by and see me anytime you want to. Cause I'm always here at home till closing time. I'm always here at home till closing time.
Thank you very much. Now I'd like to introduce somebody to you that I've known for a few years. As a matter of fact, we worked together when she was about 11 years old out in California. She's real cute then. Now she's even more beautiful. Let's make her welcome Miss Molly B.
I'm going to see how much longer we have to go.
I was just wondering.
So we're here. We're all the way down. We start
here. How much? This is like a whole music thing at the end. We could stop it and then just like play it all night. I don't even mind country music. I'm not even sure how much I can take. Damn.
So let's just go on down here. Fast forward.
They're still going.
Even Jeans gets into it too.
Crikey. They're actual, they were actual country singers in this, so they all like had their spotlight. But yeah, I'd rather an episode of Hee Haw than this one.
Yeah, that's me currently right there. This movie's giving me the Forrest Whitaker eye. there's even more.
Forrest Whitaker eye, I like that.
Oh, my God. Oh, my heaven's sakes. Right, let's keep going. Let's go. Oh, he's even got to get in there. That's got to be the end. Oh, my God. There we go, everybody. The end. Oh, my God. Oh, well, just lost a few more brain cells watching that one. You guys thought the last movie was bad. You're welcome. Oh, my God. Fucking horrible.
that was pretty bad.
Oh, God.
Oh, wow. Damn. I thought that was going to be a little bit faster paced as well. That could have been cut in half pacing wise. Jesus.
30 minutes. Cut out the friggin' music. I mean, you're going in, it said musical, and I'm thinking it was kind of like what was that movie we did with a little bit more up music, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
This was horrible.
My brain.
This was just a vehicle for country music. That's all this was.
That's what it was. Yeah. Yeah. And I did see like this actual, very well-known country singers involved in it. And I just thought, especially with the director, that it was going to be a lot funnier because the Abbott and Costello ones were funny, and you know, but hey ho. Y'all.
Well, there's a reason why this was the director's final movie, I think. He was like, fuck this shit, I'm out. Directing it probably gave him
damn. Yeah. I have to take the hit on this one. This was my suggestion, so my apologies. Oh my god.
But the gorilla. The gorilla was locked up, but the gorilla keep popping up. So what does it do? Keep locking itself up in the cage afterwards?
Like, yes. God. Oh, yeah, that was horrendous.
You can't even rationalize this one.
No, I was coping okay in the beginning. I didn't mind, you know, some of the music because I thought, well, okay, you know, we've got the country music theme going, we've got actual country singers in it, but that last, I thought, oh no, it yeah, took us through a whole show. Oh my god.
This must have been a contractual obligating kind of movie for Basil Rathbone and
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know what the deal was with this. I mean, obviously if they as you said, if there were contracts involved perhaps, but probably more so for Rathbone maybe, but I'm not sure. I was reading up when I was dying of boredom on Lon Chaney Jr.'s life. And if anybody's interested, that is worth having a look on Wiki. Just an incredible life. Very tragic, you know, a lot of tragedy in his life, obviously. And I was noticing in this film, he just looked really unwell. And he was actually the same age as John Carradine in this film. They were both 61 from my calculations. And you could see the difference in how they appeared. John Carradine was around till about 82 years old. And he was only 61 in this. So he obviously did much better, but Chaney passed away fairly young in comparison to Carradine. So you can see it, you know, he just didn't look well of him.
Yeah.
But
it's a shame. Wow. Okay.
This was a stinker.
Well, if everyone's still with us and watching this one and not asleep, they're staying with us to the end. Let us know your rating on this one. Mine's a solid minus zero.
And that's just for the music, I'm betting. I actually, like I said, I have great respect. And a lot of attachment to classical country music because of where I, you know, just growing up, I was kind of surrounded by it, but this movie was just, it was just all over the place. Yeah, it's like 1 out of 10 for me, you know, 1 out of 10. I mean, 1 for, the cast, maybe. Lon Chaney Jr., Basil Rathbone. Yeah, but that's it.
I'm going to go listen to Pink Floyd to cleanse my palate. I
know. Yeah, definitely.
And before we go, let's have a look to see what we're doing next weekend. And believe me, we are.
It's a lot better.
It's a lot better. Here we go.
Ruthless invaders. A defenseless planet. Battle beyond the stars. A lone youth escapes on a last-ditch mission that begins at the edge of the universe. story of a boy who finds more than he expected.
Make them burn.
And all he can handle.
Does your species have kissing?
Oh, yes. We have that.
Try one. That's a hot dog. It comes from Earth. Do you like it?
There's no dog in this.
Mm-mm.
Soybean meal, niacin, dextrose, and sodium nitrate flavoring. That's what we call meat back home.
Battle beyond the stars. Starring Richard Thomas, George Papard, Robert Vaughn, John Saxon, a battle beyond time, beyond space.
Nice and fire!
That ends in a desperate gamble.
They'll be able to board us.
It won't make any difference.
Get that hatch open! No!
Battle beyond the stars.
Yeah. Now we talk about pacing. That trailer could have used a major edit on that one, I think.
Yes, wow. Definitely.
That one. Anyways, Battle Beyond the Stars is next weekend. I'm looking forward to doing that one. Good movie. Great soundtrack.
Yep. Yep. That was a lot of fun.
All right. Well,
right,
that's it, everybody.
So, yeah. So thanks to those who made it to the end. Congratulations.
Deserve a hero cookie for this one. All right. Goodbye, everybody.
All right. Take care, everybody.
That's all, folks.